AWR, that's Autonomous Water Rover, was an industrial project required by an organization called Advance. They talked to us and they said that these are the specific things that we require. We require basically monitoring of the health of a lake body, lake or any small pond water body. And we thought that, yeah, it was doable because we were already thinking along the same lines, like any water cleanings, rover or something like that. This is a timeline of the project wherein not about the technical aspects, but how we met people, because that is one of the really important things in this whole thing. The first photo you can see on the left-hand side, that was our first prototype, and you can see the top right photo. So you can see the difference. But with that first photo, we actually won the first prize at the 17th International Conference on Embedded Systems. From there, we went, we had gone to the maritime exhibition where we met Navy officers, and they told us that what are the requirements, what you should think about when you're doing this project. Then we went to Goa at NIO. NIO is the National Institute of Oceanography. And there, they have a lot of projects in marine robotics. Now, marine robotics in India is not very booming right now. In the world also, it's not very much booming. It's there in Norway, in US, I guess, but it's not really that much there. But we still saw there are projects. These are not the Indian projects. The center image on the top, it's a snake. So they have basically replicated the movements of the sea snakes so that it can go underwater and behave. It can get information about the water health parameters. It can also understand, it can help in research to the biologists and similar people.
It was a proper industrial trade show, and we just like the generic cold mail, what you say, contact@inmex.com. So we mailed to the person there for some asking permission to display, and we got it. So a stall which was costing our neighbor around 3 lakhs, we got it for free. So try and approach people, they're approachable through the internet. So that is one thing, especially in the initial stages when you don't have the money and you need to just get that initial steps going. So what problem we are facing, like you saw in these devices, all the hull is the most important part. So that is made of carbon fiber or something like that. So we kind of, like through his suggestion, we kind of figured out a solution which costed us 1,000 rupees. So we just took ready-made PVC pipes, which are waterproof, and we joined them together. So that was kind of that was one of the key moments which drove our project forward. So without the hull, we couldn't do anything. Point of going to that industrial exhibition was to get 2 pumps. So we saw on the website that they're going to be there at this exhibition. We thought if we displayed and showed them a prototype, we could get it. And that happened. So he told us that don't even call this as a sponsorship, just take it like this only. So it was 5,000 was a huge amount to us then, but they gave it to us like for free.
eYantra's obviously was the best competition, I guess, among the three, because we got to meet a lot of people, we got a lot of ideas, we got a lot of contacts, and that really helped us to boost in general, not for this project, but for our life, that we need to talk to people, and only then we will be able to move forward.